Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 14.2.1 and 14.3 Beta 2 have been out for a little while. I haven't done a follow-up on them, so I thought I'd do a follow-up going over the experience of them and also talk about when to expect iOS 14.2.2 and the release of 14.3. So I'll talk about all of that a little bit later, but I first wanted to talk about the overall experience. Now, the first thing is, if you're using iOS 14.2.1 or maybe you're not seeing that update, there's going to be a reason for that, and generally that's because 14.2.1 was specific to the iPhone 12 series. So this is the iPhone 12 Pro Max that I have it running on here, and it fixed three different major issues and had some security updates, but the major issue it fixed was with the iPhone 12 mini with touch responsiveness lag on the home screen. It fixed a couple other things as well, but that was the major issue that it fixed. So that, along with an issue with MMS messages not being received, as well as the iPhone hearing devices not working properly with the 12 series. So it fixed all of those things, and that's working fine on iPhone 12. Now, one issue that a lot of people are complaining about with iOS 14.2 is that they're having some lag with the keyboard, and generally people typing have lag with the keyboard with messages, and it seems like it's fixed in 14.2.1. So why Apple only pushed it to the iPhone 12 and not to older devices is hard to say, but I think we'll see an update to hopefully fix some of those issues here soon in the future. Now, as far as anything else in that update, well, 14.2.1 seems pretty solid. Battery life is pretty solid. So I'll talk about the battery life here and then talk about 14.3. But battery life on this device has been pretty good. It easily gets me through a day, no problem. And it's kind of hit or miss. So you'll see I only got about 2 hours or 1 hour and 55 minutes of screen on time, 1 hour and 4 minutes of screen off time, and used about a quarter of the battery. That was yesterday. Depending on the day, it varies greatly. But the odd thing is I'm not sure these numbers are correct. And the reason I say that is I can easily get through about a day and a half with the 12 Pro Max right now. So I'm not really seeing this screen on time. Maybe it's accurate and I just am not using it that much, but it seems kind of odd that I have phenomenal battery life. I'll go to bed, put it on the charger at about 60%, and then I'll have it charged in the morning again. So it's kind of odd. I'm not sure if they need to fix something in the background with that, but right now battery life seems fine despite what the numbers say here. Now, also with 14.3 beta 2, well, that's pretty good for most people. I think this is the update that will really make iOS 14 very stable. It's pretty stable already. It has a few little bugs like the keyboard issue, as well as system crashes for some. Those were the two major issues I saw on the YouTube community poll based off what people were saying with 14.2. Those that are running 14.3 beta 2 are not seeing any issues and are saying performance is great. So while it's an early beta, it's not perfect. It seems to be okay. So if we go into things like music, you can see how fast it loaded. If we go into weather, for example, they're opening equally fast on the iPhone 6S Plus and the iPhone 12 Pro. If we go into the App Store, for example, they're both loading for the first time in this update. We'll give it a moment and you'll see it was fairly fast on both. Again, we'll go into the cameras, takes a second to load, and actually the 6S Plus was faster there. So performance-wise, it seems to be really decent. Other than that, I haven't really seen a whole lot of people say there's bugs with 14.3. And that's a great sign. So that means once it's out to the public, it will be very stable, I think, for most. With the iPhone 7, for example, many people are saying similar things. If they're on 14.2, it might be getting warm, it might lag, but once they're on 14.3 betas, they seem to be okay. Speed seems fine. Opening different apps are fine. And I know some people will say this is an iPhone 8. This is an iPhone 7 in jet black. So if you look up that one, you'll see it. But a lot of people think it's an iPhone 8, but it's actually a 7. It's an aluminum back instead of glass. So we'll go home here and we'll go into settings. You'll see everything seems to be smooth. And again, on the beta, it seems to be okay. Now, as far as the iPad, this is where I've been using this primarily with 14.3 or iPadOS 14.3 beta 2. So I haven't had any crashes. In fact, I've had great everything overall except battery life. So you'll see in the upper right, I have 33% battery life. If I go into my battery here, we'll wait for it to load, and you'll see I last charged it to 100% on Tuesday. That was 3 or 4 days ago now. And you'll see I've used it. I haven't used it a ton this week. I've been playing around with the M1 Max. But if I go to screen on time, usually about an hour or so a day. And if we go back to Tuesday, it charged and then I used it 3 minutes. So that is not great battery life. I would say that I'm getting about 6 hours if I was to use it continuously, just watching YouTube. And you'll see the lock screen is using a lot. So I need to turn off some notifications there. That seems to be using the most power. But YouTube is what I use with it most, and photos and things like that. But again, crashes, stability, performance, and everything is really great. It's just battery life, but it's a beta, so I don't really expect great battery life. So when will the next update be? Well, I think we'll see iOS 14.3 beta 3 this coming week. Currently, at least at the time of recording this, this is sort of the week of and weekend of Thanksgiving, so I don't expect anything there, but I do expect an update the following week, maybe on Tuesday or so. That's generally when Apple releases them. However, they've been releasing them sometimes late in the day. Who knows? We could even see one during a weekend at this point. It's been kind of crazy right now, but hopefully it'll be fairly standardized a little bit later. Now, as far as iOS 14.2.2, well, depending on what Apple decides, we could see a public release with some minor bug fixes to every device, hopefully soon. Again, I would expect that this coming week or the first week of December really is when we see updates after the holidays in the United States. So that's really what I'm looking for as far as public releases, although I do expect Apple to release iOS 14.3 sometime in December with that Apple Pro Raw update for the iPhone 12 Pro series. So I'm thinking that release will be then. Maybe we'll see a minor update this coming week as well. If we don't see it, I would expect them just to wait to 14.3 at this point. But again, Apple has been so random at this point, it's really hard to determine exactly what they're doing. Now, other than that, let's take a look at the YouTube community poll and see what you had to say. So we'll go into YouTube. You can see RAM management was good. This has been sitting in the background for an hour or so before filming this video. So at the time of this video, you'll see there's 12,000 votes. And this was a little bit difficult to do the poll because you only get five options. So you can see I said iOS 14.3 beta 2, great or not so great. And then again, 14.2.1, great and not so great. So 14.2.1 is mostly great, and 14.3 beta 2 is decent. Again, and a lot of people are over 50% are using 14.2 itself. So let me go ahead and sort these. And you'll see a lot of people are commenting with 14.2. So the first one from Cynical Teddy says 14.2 on an iPhone 11 Pro Max. Battery life is better than 14. iMessage still has an annoying lag before text input shows up. And a new bug with 14.2 is that notifications for iMessages come and go and is very irritating. Surprised Apple has taken this long to fix the notification bugs that multiple people all over Reddit have complained about. And that's the last thing I meant to mention is there's those three things: messages, some random crashes, and keyboard lag. Gabriel says, 12 mini on 14.2.1, bit of animation stuttering when opening apps, but otherwise can't complain. Stanley says he's still on iOS 13.6.1 with an iPhone 8, still worrying about battery life on 14. I don't know if I'm being paranoid though. Once iOS 14.3 comes out, I would update. In fact, 13.7 was better than 13.6.1, and many people said 14.1 was better than 13.7, so I really wouldn't worry about that. Really, really good battery life on 14.3. iPhone 7 Plus battery at 99%, I get 6.5 hours of screen on time. Nicholas says, I'm on iOS 14.3 beta 2 on iPhone 11 Pro and battery life has been amazing. Russell says, working smooth as butter on my iPhone XR, no hiccups, stable battery life, just that the auto light and dark mode wasn't switching properly a couple of times. That's actually based on when it's daylight and night out. So based on sunset, it actually switches. So depending on when that is throughout the day, generally it will flip at that time. Chris Roberto says, iOS 14.2, so far it's running great on all of my devices, iPhone SE 2 and iPhone 7, but battery life still needs improvement. We'll read a couple more. There's hundreds of comments, so I appreciate it. 14.2, sometimes it runs smooth, sometimes it feels very laggy on the iPhone 8 Plus. Polkit says, using iOS 14.2 on iPhone XR, the battery life seems to be resuming to normal, 7 to 8 hours of screen on time, no bugs or slowdowns. Everything is fine except iMessage and Siri. I'm using iPhone 7, iOS 14.3, beta 2. Otto says, still having the keyboard lag, and now the iMessage notification bug is back. And so that's it for iOS 14.3 beta 2 and iOS 14.2.1. Like I said earlier, hopefully we see iOS 14.3 beta 3 this coming week in a few days from now. And also iOS 14.2.2 would be great to see. If Apple wants to skip that and jump right to a final version of iOS 14.3, I think many would welcome it as long as they've had time to actually make sure it's really solid. And I think we're going to see more and more of that very soon. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.